Perfect lunch, coffee break. I would like only to spend some word to present my institute, but not more than a couple of minutes. The Instituto for his work of penicillin, and after the Second World War, in this institute we produced all the penicillin that need for our countries. And then also Daniel Beauvais worked in this institute, and the last is Rita Levi-Montalcini, that is also nominated from Italian President of the Republic as a senator for life in our Republic's Senate. The mission of ISS is the leading technical and scientific body for the Italian National Health Service. Its activities include research, clinical trials, control and training in public health, including food safety, of course. It's involved in collaboration and consultation with other institutions responsible for public health, including the Ministry of Health, Regional Health Authority, Local Health Agency, and hospitals. It plays a leading role in several major international research projects. This is the organization of the National Institute for Health. We have seven departments. One of these departments is the Department of Veterinary Public Health and Food Safety that hosts this meeting. In the Veterinary Public Health and Food Safety is divided in 40 different units. One of those units is Microbiological Foodborne Hazard, and I am the head of this unit. The Microbiological Unit works in different fields of the food safety, and you can see some posters that describe the activity of this unit, and also we have three presentations on the activity of this union. Especially we have presentation of the National Reference Laboratory for Viral Contamination Muscles, and another presentation was to describe the activity of the National Reference Center for Botulism. We have different institutional and research activities. The institutional activity is to perform second opinion analysis case or legal controversy in the result of the official analysis. Intervene in the case of reporting of microbiological contamination at the community level, as well as an episode of food poisoning in connection with the Italian reference alert system. Collaborate in the monitoring to evaluate the prevalence of the different agents in the human and food products. promoted the dissemination of information and participated in education activities within the scope of its competence, performing studies for the analysis of risk associated with the presence of viral and bacterial agents and their toxins in various food medicines and along the product chain. Develop a validated cultural and innovative method of analysis for the bacteria and virus identification and typing. Promote the dissemination information, organization, training activity within the scope of its competence. Also, we have a lot of research activities. I don't know what to describe all, but the expertise that we have with the research activities allowed us to participate at 10 different, 9, Europe, 10 probably, why not? For now, only 9 different European projects. And also in our institute, we have 3 community European reference laboratory for the parasites, for the E. coli, for the chemical elements food of animal origins. This is a short presentation of the of my institution and my unit. Now I present the first talk about interdisciplinary activities that we performed in our institute when happened an outbreak. So this is an example of different different work that we have had for outbreaks. For example, in this moment we have another task force that work for the some cases of TDCA viruses outbreaks correlated with case with the massive consumption in Campania regions. This is an example of the work that we did in 2013. About cases of outbreaks of TDCA in Italy associated with frozen food berries. On May 2013, Germany, the Netherlands, and Poland reported through the epidemic intelligence information system for food and waterborne disease and the early warning response system of the European Community 15 cases of hepatitis A infection associated with a ski holiday in autonomous province of Trento and Bolzano in the north of Italy. Following the European alert concerning those HIV cases, a series of actions were immediately undertaken by the Italian health authorities in order to identify the occurrence of an epidemic outbreak, eventually manage and control the outbreaks. Many other autochthon cases of HIV infection were identified during this preliminary investigation, suggesting that an epidemic outbreak occurred. Very early during the outbreak, on the 23 May 2013, the Minister of Health designated a multidisciplinary task force to coordinate at the national level the investigation of the outbreak in Italy. The outbreak investigation included descriptive epidemiology and the case control study, microbiological testing of food specimen, molecular type of positive human and food specimen, and food tracing investigations. The task force included experts in different fields, as public health and veterinary epidemiologists, virologists, food safety microbiologists, experts in traceback activity, and the Italian National Labs for Contact Point. The aim of that task force were the epidemiology investigation of human cases, the microbiological testing of food specimen and the genotyping of the virus isolated in human and food specimen. Preliminary investigation, according with the European CDC, were concentrated in the area of the northern Italy where the German, Polish and Dutch cases are traveled. The sequence of PUP1 to A regions, that is a very characteristic region for genotype the hepatitis A viruses, or the viruses, resulting for 5 resident cases, 1 Dutch case, and 2 German cases, show the 100% of sequence identity. The sequence of outbreaks was submitted to GenBank. GenBank accession number KF182323. The preliminary investigation showed that only food common to the different cases were mixed frozen berries. One sample of mixed berries has been found positive to HIV detection, and alert was rapidly communicated through RASP system. The results were published as a rapid communication very early because the group started to work at the 23 of May. We published the 31 of May, the first results. In Italy, hepatitis A is a mandatory report to Italian National Surveillance System. In parallel, in order to improve the surveillance and to promote the investigation of risk factors associated with acute viral hepatitis, a Sentinel Surveillance System for acute viral hepatitis, SEIEVA, was implemented in 1984, aimed to monitor the potential risk factor associated with the disease. Standardized questionnaires were used to systematically collect information on risk factors associated with the HIV infection, ingestion of well water, consumption of at-risk food, including frozen berries, travel to endemic countries, contact and close contact with the confirmed cases. The data collected by SEIEVA system from 2010-2014 is reported in this slide, and the distribution of the HIV cases shows that an epidemic peak was observed during the 2013, with a decreasing trend at the end of the year from November 2013. From 1st January 2013 to the end of February 2014, a total of 1,463 cases of HIV were reported in Italy. The highest number of cases